Hey everyone, so today we are celebrating one of the best players in basketball, Kobe Bryant. It's really someone I really appreciate what he's done all his life and his success. It's an amazing player. And myself, I'm playing basketball. So to contribute to to commemorate him, and it's really sad. And so I decided today just to stop all my laboring, stop all my production, and just doing a new desserts to commemorate his memory. So I make some little balls, basketballs. So they are made with mango mousse, coconut sponge, and inside there is a center of caramelized banana with a bit of pineapple, passion fruit. So it's a very exotic mix. And I think I'm gonna call the Black Mamba. So tomorrow there will be in my shop with the label called Black Mamba. So yeah, let's make it. Okay, so we're gonna start with 375 egg white. Those ones are pasteurized one. Yeah, can use fresh, it's the same. So this, we're gonna whip it with 180 caster sugar. So that will make the meringue. Okay. And get ready with your desiccated coconut, 240 grams. With the same amount of icing sugar, 240. There we go. Up, this we're gonna give a little whisk. This has to be ready before you start the meringue, otherwise the meringue won't hold too long, yeah? So just mix icing sugar and the desiccated coconuts together. All right, so let's do the meringue. So when it starts to go foamy, we're gonna add the sugar gradually. Here, little bit. Add a little bit more. All of it. And we're gonna let it whip until it goes nice and firm, yeah? Okay, so this is nice and firm. Okay, it almost has a creamy consistency. You see? It's fine. Okay, let's put that in a bowl. And we're gonna mix it with our icing sugar and desiccated coconut. So it's gluten-free, which is great. We're gonna just fold it in. So this makes you breathe lots of icing sugar. We're gonna jump at the end of the day. Very gentle, so you don't lose the air. Once it's all mixed, you can just stop. Yeah, we're gonna pipe it on a tray and bake it. Okay, so I'm using a nozzle of 13 millimeter, and this whole batch should cover the whole tray, 60 centimeter by 40 centimeter. Do the frame first, and then I'm gonna fill it up. Okay, so this goes in the oven at 170 degrees for 22 minutes. Okay, so now we're gonna caramelize the banana. So those ones are not totally ripe because you're gonna caramelize them, so you want them to stay as whole as possible. So if you take them too ripe, it will go mashy puree too quickly, yeah? Okay. I wonder if I should put some alcohol.
Yeah!
No! No!
Oh.
No, you know, you could caramelize your banana with a flambé dark rum, but we're gonna use some passion fruit, a mango mousse, so maybe let's keep it classic with no alcohol. So we're gonna shank the bananas that kind of thickness. The pan is warming up because we're gonna do a caramel. Okay, that should do. Just gonna open the butter for later. Okay, let's see if it's hot. So we're gonna use some brown sugar, demerara sugar. Okay, so it has melted now. We're gonna put a little bit more. Let it melt. Okay, it's nice and caramel now. We're gonna deglaze it with a bit of butter before to put the banana. Let's put our bananas. Then I'm cutting few passion fruits that will bring some acidity and an amazing flavor. So we will stop getting too much color anymore. Thank you. And I was just thinking right now, why not putting a bit of pineapples also? Just enough. Ready to make it more exotic. There. And we're gonna let glaze them, all those fruity into that caramel. Okay, now it has dried out, but you want a bit more cooking. So I'm gonna put at this stage some mango puree or mango juice. I'm using mango puree here because I can't get very nice mango. And this mango puree is delicious. It's like a proper extract of the fruit. Gonna reduce the heat and let it bubble gentle. Let's test. Yeah, it's good. Okay, so this is done. Okay, we still have lumps. That's perfect. We're gonna reserve it into a bowl and let it cool down, yeah? It smells amazing. So exotic. I would have got some lime. I think I would have a little drop of lime. But I don't have a few zest for the fresh fragrance. I don't have. Shame. Ahaha! This is ready. So we're gonna put it straight on a rack so the sponge doesn't dry. Okay? Oh, it was starting to bubble, so I poke it with a knife and we have a hole now. So now we're gonna start our fruit mousse, mango mousse. So we have 650 gram whipped cream, which I whipped previously. I'm gonna reserve it in the fridge. Here I'm gonna start to do a syrup to make an Italian meringue. So it's 220 caster sugar. One third of it as water. I'm gonna put it on the stove. Okay, then 110 gram egg white. Come on. So those ones are pasteurized, but you can use fresh, it's fine. Ready into the mixer. So we are waiting for syrup to reach 121. When it's 114, you can start your egg white to whip and time the from the 114 reach to the 121, this will have whipped perfectly to pour the syrup in. That's all. Oh, not that's all. Actually, we're gonna get ready our puree. So we need 250 gram in one pot. Okay, so this one is gonna be warmed up and mixed with gelatin. And here, this one, we're gonna put 500 gram, which we're gonna keep it cold. You understand why? That's it. Mm. It's delicious. So this one, we reserve it in the fridge, cold, or semi-freddo. This one, we're gonna warming up. Let's see the syrup, what temperature is. It's nearly 114. Okay, so now we're gonna start our egg white. Okay guys, so this is 119.7. It's nearly 121, so we stop now because it carry on to cook with the heat of the pan, yeah? And the egg whites are ready. Nice and whipped. So now we're gonna pour our syrup gently. Uh-huh. And now we're gonna let it whip and let it cool down, yeah? Once it's all combined, like that, you can reduce the speed and just let it cool down, yeah? Okay. All right, so now we're gonna get ready our gelatin leaves. So a container with cold water. And we need the 10 and a half gelatins, 10 and a half leaves, which we're gonna weigh them up because not everyone has the same. Okay. Quatre, six, huit, ten. Okay, so you need 34 grams of gelatin in total. So those goes in cold water to soften. Okay, so the meringue is cold now, so it's ready to do our mix with the puree. So what we need to do is try to grab a whisk as the first thing you need to do. We're gonna warm up those 250 gram puree, warming up hot so we can melt our gelatin inside. Meringue can be stopped. And we're gonna stir the meringue with the whipped cream. So that's our whipped cream. And we're gonna mix it with the meringue, which is cold. If the meringue's warm, it's gonna melt your whipping. And you don't want that. Okay, so you have your mix, whipped cream and meringue here, waiting for the puree. Let's go back to our puree. That's simmering, so that means it's hot. So we're gonna remove the gelatin from the water. Squeeze the excess of water. Okay, and we're gonna melt it into our warm puree. Take it out of the stove. So now this mix has to cool down before to mix it with the cream. So that's why we have our 500 remaining cold. So this one is slightly frozen, which is perfect. It will help cool down much quicker. So I'm gonna transfer the hot into the cold. Let's mix that. At this stage, if you see it stay liquid that doesn't set, let it set first before to mix it with the cream. But don't let it overset as well. You see it has thickened a bit, so that means the gelatin start to work. So we're gonna mix it right now. Otherwise, after it be setting too hard and it be too late, okay? If it's too late, if it becomes too hard, warming up slightly. You need to have this creamy consistency, thick, okay? So you put a little bit of cream just to lose that mix. So you won't have any lumps into your mousse. Okay, and then once you have mixed that together, put it back into the rest of your cream. Just need one whisk, yeah, really. And do some light movements, yeah, like that. So you incorporate air inside. Don't go too quick. If you go like brrrr, all your mix, your mousse gonna go down, it'll be quite dense. You want something very light, like your move. Make sure it's well mixed everywhere. That's it. All right, so now we've got our mousse, we've got our inserts, banana, pineapple, mango, passion fruit, caramelized, fantastico. And we got our dacquoise, coconut. So we're just gonna build them. Here it is. Nice and very light. So, to unmold it, up. I'll remove the paper. Okay, so I'm not sure which kind of size we need to cut the sponge. We're gonna do a try. So if we put, I think that might be good actually. So let's cut one biscuit. Let's do it. So a bit of mousse. Then we're gonna put our sponge. Yeah, that will be good. Yes. Then we're gonna put that all around. And I need a spoon. John? I've seen that. What did you eat again?
What did you?
Little bit of this center here. Then just move it up We're all gonna make them like that. Okay, so this has been in the freezer. We're gonna unmold them. Okay, so and once that's all unmold, we're gonna put them together and make a basketball shape. So I'm gonna put them together, stick them with mousse. Okay, so now we're creating the lines of the ball with a hot blade. Alright guys, so we've done some melted cocoa butter, colored orange. I'm just gonna pour that in. Oh, looks a bit dangerous. So I'm gonna use this paint sprayer gun. I'm not gonna put the end bit because this might block the sprayer. There we go. Okay guys, so my gun is look like it's broken, so I'm using this to do the create the velour, which is not very ideal, but I don't have much choice here. Ah, such a shame. So you see the fat set straight away on the frozen mousse. It creates a whole of a mess. I need to do it from far, so I have a very fine effect. Ah, very disappointing about my gun. Okay. Oh my god! Okay, let's put them back in the freezer quickly. Oh, they look so cool. So now we're gonna clean the mess, and then we will do the lines. So okay, it's okay, I'm gonna clean it. Okay, so now we're just making the lines. Really need the steady hands, it's not easy. Does it look good? Okay, guys, that's it. John helped me to clean actually this time. So it's all clean. It's great. Thank you, John. So yeah, that's all. Our little bubbles. I hope, I really wish that the lines will have come out better, but I need to work on that. So that will go straight away in the shop tomorrow. That's all, guys. Please like the video and subscribe. See you. Alright, guys, the Black Mamba dessert.